Hi guys, I hope you can see this okay. I'm sorry that I can't zoom in any further, but I've got a new camera, well, new computer, and I've not had a chance to put all the software on it properly. I thought I did put the right software on for so I can zoom in because I use two different programs. Well, I use this to film, and then I've got another little program that I use to zoom my camera and change it to black and white and stuff, but I can't remember what software it is. And it means I need to go in and set up my other computer and try and find it. So, and it's like 1:30, 12:30 in the morning. Well, morning or night, I don't know. But anyway, D class 12 a. Well, I suppose it's a.m. and I'm rambling. Sorry, guys. But anyway, it's really late, and I can't be bothered messing about with software and trying to find things and setting up other computers, because this is actually, I've took the plugs out that computer to put this one in because the other plugs are still at my brother's, because we were in a rush to get out, so I didn't have a chance. Well, I did have a chance to pack it, but I chose not to because we were in a hurry, and I've got the plugs and stuff at home, so from other computer. I've actually got another computer, but that I could probably set it up with. But anyway, so I hopefully, like, things that are really hard to see, I'll try and hold up and stuff like that. But I just thought I'd come on and do a quick flip through of my journal, because I've done a few pages since I last showed you it. And yeah, so anyway, you've seen most of the pages, like these ones. I'll try hold it up like this. But it is a big jumble, so it's quite difficult. But I'll try my best. So, this is the first page I did with the butterflies in the background, and then I made the butterfly tag. I've done that on video. I just wrote a wee, like, note on the back about getting motivated, doing more YouTube videos and stuff like that. So, yeah, so that's that, and I just put a wee clear pocket in there, and that's just a little journal card that I made. Nothing on it really, it's just, I just cut it out from some double-sided 12x12, so there's not really a lot on it. There's some washi tape on this side, but I'm using it to decorate it. I wasn't using it to use in the journal. And then I get this little sticker here, which you probably can't see that well, but I liked it. It's, you know, I got that as well from my new trainers, and I chose to put that on there, or sneakers, whatever you call them, wherever you are. And then this is just random cuts, scraps that I've put on there. That kind of looks like a duck, doesn't it? I just noticed that there on the camera. It looks a bit like a duck. I just noticed that. And then I did this page with the sunflower on it for my friend Sonny, in memory of my friend Sonny. My little envelope that I made, I've got a video on this as well. And then what I chose to do was, what was this? Oh, this is a little tag that I made for the envelope, which I really, really love as well. I love this tag. I'm really proud of this tag, actually. And this is just a little note of comments that I got in the videos for this. So I wrote some of the comments down and put them in with the envelope, and I don't know where my sticky tapes went to now, but yeah. And then that's just the back of that. This is just a bit of tracing paper with a napkin on it and some ink dense colouring, I think it was. And then I've got this little girl, this girl here, and the little small bits beside her say, love, 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 don't. Oh, I'm trying to see it upside down because I'm showing you is it the right way up. So hang on a wee sec, just I'll read out what it says. I made them really, really tiny because, well, I didn't make them really tiny, but in the catalogue they were really tiny. It's actually a bedding set, I think. So it says, love, laugh, love, don't worry, be happy, and always find a reason to smile. So that was what I done on that page. I'll try and not take too long with this, guys, but there is a lot in it, but I'll try my best not to take too long. And I'm just trying to find the right way to hold this up again. Try this. So, there's that, and then that's a butterfly as well. What I did with that, the butterflies, and then there's a little paperclip thing that somebody gave me. This is me just writing about how my brother brought my dinner to me when I wasn't well, and that's the tin foil from it, because he puts tin foil and all that on it to keep it, he plates it up and then puts tin foil over it to keep it warm when he's driving over to see me. So these here, I done these a long time ago, and basically what I did was I did it with Inktense blocks, and I just put some of the colour on my brush, and then I brushed it onto the stamp. This one you can see better because it's got like the two different colours, you see? So I just brushed the colour onto the stamp and then stamped it on. So, and then I made this cupcake page. This journal is getting a bit ripped and stuff because I have been like using it a lot, and there's tails in it, but I like it because it is a junk journal. So, and then that was just a napkin on book page, a cupcake napkin, and then I made this little cupcake ATC last year. No, it might have been, was it last year? Might have been the year before. I made this ATC. I've got a video of this somewhere as well on my channel. I made it for International Crafters. Is that right? It ain't going on, guys. What the heck? Right, okay. Right, and then beside it there, I got a little sticker. And it says, hi there, cupcake. And then that one, it says, the best part of the muffin top is the best part. So, yeah. And then I've got this one here. It's just a black and white image. I love black and white images. And it's on one of those, you know, those bags where the... I can't speak tonight, guys. I'm really tired. But anyway, you know what I'm talking about. One of the paper bags that you get. That was given to me as well. I think it was Karen McClure that sent me this. And then inside that... I don't think there's anything inside that, is there? Yeah, there is. There's, like... There's a magazine images of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and I put it in there because it wasn't so long ago that I found this, that Gene Wilder died, so I was planning to do like a kind of tribute page, but I've not had the time to do that yet, so I've just stuck that in there. Anyway, I've got a silver black and white image, and I don't know if you'll remember the big books that I got a few months ago. It was like the antiques, and you know, it told you what it was worth and stuff like that. So this was one of the images in there. This here was just a page that I tore out a star sign book, and I was trying out a stencil that I got in Happy Mail. I can't remember for the life of me who sent me it again. Sorry guys, I have no working tonight, and whoever it is, you all know when you see anyway, hopefully. Yeah, just let me know in the comments who it was. I probably will remember when I finish this video, but this was a Colour Nun page, one of the adult Colour Nun books. And I just put that in there. I was planning to like write down everything I watched on this, and you can see here I've got some of these little scenic cut stickers, and I had that all down the side, and I was going to write what I'd watched and when I'd watched it, but I didn't keep up with that. And then I've got a little owl page here. It's just gift wrap, and I just made it into a page. And then this is a little tag that I got from one of the embellishments, and I just thought I'd use it as a tag or something. And I put that in there, and that's actually peeling up, you see that? This here, it was just me writing, I didn't even know what I was writing about. Oh yeah, I was complaining because I hadn't had chocolate for over a week, and I was saying that I was going to go down at midnight to go to the Asda and get some when I get my money in the bank. So that was me just ranting because I hadn't had chocolate for over a week, and that is so not like me. But yeah, and then it's just on some 6x6 paper. I draw a wee bit in there. That was me just writing about my date with my brothers, my Sunday, when I went over for my dinner. I was just talking about how he was whistling and stuff whilst he was in making the dinner. And then this was a stencil, and I just coloured it in. I drew it out and then coloured it in. And then I liked this page. It was for an optician's or glasses or maybe a laser treatment. I can't remember exactly what it was for, but I liked the image. I thought it was cool. And that's actually glued on there. It's glued on the back of a comic book page. Let's see. And then this one, it's just a wee book page I stuck in there, and I just stuck the flower on it. This here is my bed set that I got, and I just wrote a bit about that in the back of it. The other evil gift wrap page, this here was the first card that I ever made. Hang on. My screen's went black, and I like to see what I'm showing you. So it was for a new house. It was just while we're making random cards in the art class. And as you can see, I've not wrote in it, but I did put in a handmade by Annie Collins in that one. And then the other side. And then this, I was planning to like cover it with all sorts of pencil pictures, but these are the only two that I've found so far. I love that. I want that pencil case so bad. I think it's so cool. And then that was my bedding set, the other side. So I just put the hand there pointing to it. This was just napkin on book page. I really love that effect. The other side of the comic book, so I've not really done anything on this page yet. Or anything on any of these pages yet, so I've still got quite a few pages to fill out. This is just a little pocket here, and this was a little card that I got when I bought something from someone. I can't remember the name of the shop now, or I would have told you, but I can't remember. I can't remember, but this was the little tag that I got when I'm placing my order. When I got my order, I mean. This was a page I'd done the other night. It's just a wee ATC, like the one I showed you at the front. And I just stuck this flower in here, was it Bridget? I think it was Bridget Downey that sent me this. It was originally yellow, but I wanted to make it red, so I kind of went over it with some red paint. I think it was Inktense again, actually. It was Bridget who gave me the Inktense as well. And then I put this little burlap butterfly and a little pebble in there, and then I just went round with some washi tape, and as you can see, some of it's peeling off already, so it may be glued down. And then the background is a mixture of pens, Inktense. You can't see it in the camera, but there's some metallic silver in there. And basically I was just playing around. I was just like drawing lines, and there's like, you can't really see them that well, but there is like crosses and arrows and stuff like that on it. I was just basically doodling, you could say, and making a background. So it was fun to actually do, just put colour on the page and then start scribbling over it with pen and stuff. So it was actually fun to make, and I really enjoyed it. Really relaxing. And then this is the other side of the colouring page, and we'll get into on this page yet. This is another image from that book as well. It's little girls, and I think it's a wee boy, and they're doing some art, drawing and stuff. So I thought that was quite fitting for in here. There's nothing in this side of the bag. And then this was another picture from it, and so was that. I think that was a rug or something, I can't remember. Can't remember what that was meant to be, but anyway, I like the pattern, so. And then we've got this page, I don't think I showed you this either. And this was given to me in Happy Mail as well. This was given to me in Happy Mail, so was this. And in fact, the napkin was as well. In fact, I'm trying to remember who it was. I think it was Tina Stoddart that gave me it. And I can't remember her YouTube name. I know it starts with a B, but I can't remember, but I made an actual page out of it. I'm sure it was Tina that sent me this. And then the back, there's more of these butterflies that I did with ink tents. Just a little thing to do here. This was just all sorts of inks, I think, just all stamped onto the page. And then one of my favourite pages is the napkin again on the tracing paper, and I just go over it with ink tens. And then I drew out the circles and stuff, you know, drew round the circles because that's the other side. That's the other side of that. And then there's this page, and that's just a galaxy wrapper. And you know, so it comes out, and you can open it up, and you can, I can journal in there if I want to. Oh, done it, none it yet. So, like, I wouldn't class this journal as full yet because I've still got tons of pages left to use on it. And then there's another butterfly thing. You see the two colours now? And then I put this soda wrapper on it, soda bottle wrapper. And then I got this a while back as well, with one of my tops that I bought, and I just really love the tag. It's nice flowers and stuff, so I just really, really like it. It's beautiful, so I'm using that in here. This is the leaflet from the referendum. 2016, I think it's the, try to think if this is, I think this is a Brexit one. Aye, this is a Brexit and we won, so we're leaving Europe, but it's a long process. It's going to be probably a couple of years before we actually properly leave. And then this, I just stapled on some receipts on here, nothing important, just when I've been out shopping one day I just stuck the receipts on here. And I suppose I could use them just to doodle on or journal on as well if I want to. So there's quite a few in here, so I could just like take notes or whatever on the back, or use them to make lists, maybe shopping lists or something, I don't know. But anyway, probably no shopping lists because it's actually stapled onto it, so, and I don't carry this around with me. So I don't know what I'm going to put in there. And then I've got these pages. This was one of the drawings that I had done. I can't remember if this was my first one. I can't remember. I don't know. Oh, I don't know. I think it is. I think this is one of the first drawings that I've done of a face. No, the completely first. It was one of the first that I'd done that turned out no too bad. It was Sarah Crankshaw that taught me how to do it. I don't know. I don't know if it was the first or not, but. And then I've got this as well, because I'd done that beside it, because at the time I was feeling really low, I was feeling like a failure, I was getting stressed out of myself because I kept trying to draw faces and I couldn't, and it was really getting to me, I was really getting annoyed with it. And then Sarah came on and she calmed me down and she showed me how to do it, so that was how I said, believe you can, you will. And here is just little... Oh, this is the stencils that I got. This is the ones I showed you earlier. And then there's hearts. Is it chevrons these are called? And then clover. So, yeah, so that's all that's in there. Oh, and this as well. Oh, hang on, is that something else? Oh yeah, this is a part of an envelope that sat and folded all up, and I love the pattern on it now. So I was keeping that because I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. I know I'm going to add it to this somewhere, but I just wasn't sure. And this was a little doodle owl. Prophetic, but yeah, it was one night I was watching TV and I thought, you know what, I want to doodle, so I attempted to doodle an owl. But yeah, it's pretty prophetic. But, oh well, I thought it was cute. Prophetic, but cute. And then this was another face I drew, but I kind of somehow smudged something on there, and when I rubbed it, it made it worse. So it's, you know, it's, I done this in 2015 actually. So, And then this page is one of my favourites. I love this index card that I made, and it's just mostly stickers. But I love it, the caravan, and that's stickers, and I'm sitting on a top, and it's making me feel uncomfortable. No, it's not comfy to sit on, so it was all rolled up. So, yeah, and then this was one of the ATCs that I made. The Kiwawi, is it Kiwawi? Kiwawi, I think it's called. I made that. And then this was one of my dentist appointment cards, where I was just saying that my first root canal treatment wasn't as bad as I thought, but the second one was, it was mega painful, guys. I do not recommend it to anyone, honestly. If anybody says to you it's not that bad, do not believe them, because it is. And then this is my one. It was meant to be an open page, but you know, but it turned into a kind of winter page. So yeah, as I was, you know, as I was doing it, I just I started thinking of snow and stuff like that, so it kind of turned into a winter page, but I called it open fun, but really it's, and then that's just a little tag in there. I'm trying to think of things to put in the pockets and stuff. And then this is a little book that I made, just for an A4 sheet of paper. I copied it from Jenny Bailey. So, well, I didn't copy it, she inspired me. Let's just see, she it was a tutorial she did, so I wasn't copying or copyright or anything like that. So she kind of inspired me. So I got a couple of wee bits. This one says imagine, that one says wish, and I put the fairy there. Dream big, create, and this is fly. And then the back page says self-confidence is the first request to give undertakings, great undertakings. That doesn't say request, but I don't know what it says. I can't read. I can't pronounce it. I don't know. But anyway, and you're probably all slagging me, going, "Oh, you can't read." Oh well. I can read, but I just can't read that word. This was just a little index card that I done. I was just using it to wipe up some paint, I think, off the jelly plate. And it just says, sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. And that's by Dr. Zeus, you know. And then there's another one here, and I was just talking about, I sat and had a nice wee pampering night, I had a face mask on, and I was just saying where I got the face mask from, what it was called. It was called Mango Dead Sea. That's bad, I can't even read my own writing. I don't know, but anyway, it's called Mango Dead Sea something mask. It's because it's in glitter pen as well. While I waited on my bath to fill and candles and listen to some music, felt really good just to chill and de-stress for a while. Now having a cup of soup while watching 16 and Pregnant. So that was one night I was feeling really stressed throughout the week, and I just wanted to just chill. I got myself a nice face mask from Pound Shop and put that on and just have a pamper night. This is just some washi tape. And this here is something to do with Paisley. I can't remember what it is. City of Culture, Paisley 2021 City of Culture. I don't really know what it means or what it's for, but they've got like these big plastic elephants, no, big plastic lions all around the city. So I don't, the town, so I don't really know what it is, to be honest with you, but we'll probably find out in 2020, 2021, should I say. So I'm not sure what it is exactly, but This was a picture of my laptop and in my bed set. I put the blue one in there because I couldn't get a picture of the purple one. So that's how the blue one, I've said that, I got this but it's purple. And then, oh my god, I'm only halfway through this and I'm poor. And then this is a face that I drew, but I quite liked it because it looked kind of like an alien or avatar, it reminded me of that. On this it just says, go confidently in the direction of your dreams, give that the life, live the life you imagined. So that's that. This is just a picture of my friend and me when we were younger, and I put in this nice wee butterfly on here. You're actually meant to look at it that way, so the butterfly's not actually like upside down or anything. This was a butterfly made from toilet paper, and you can see it's 3D. So, and I wrote old friend on there because it has a picture of when we were younger and stuff. This one here, I think you've seen all these, but this was a picture I drew as well. And then I made this as well. This is a little pocket on here from, it's a fabric sample from like a sofa or whatever. So I put that in there and make a pocket, and then I made this as well. It was actually from a box of chocolates, and the lid was kind of like this, and I just cut it up and used it as a template because I kind of liked it. And then I just put in a little journaling card in there, and that just clips back in there, it goes back in the pocket. It's just on a magazine page, and then I stuck this on here, something I can either doodle this or, you know, use it to write on. I made this, yes, I've seen this. I stuck this on here as well. It's just like, is it a bedroom or something? A living room, maybe. But it's black and white, and I love black and white, so that would put on there. I'm sure you won't mind me doing a long video since I haven't done one in a while, so if not, you can always stop it anyway. But if you've stuck with me this long and you watched it with me at the end, that'd be great. And I appreciate it. So this is the page where I was sticking lots of little images and stuff on it. And then this is a New Zealand stamp that I got from Nikki when she sent me my Christmas card. And then I just love this little guy, but yes, I've seen these pages, so I stuck him on there as well. I don't know if I showed you that. And then I know I done this off camera. It just says art heals the heart. And then that side, I just played with my stencils. Yes, I've seen this page, so I'm going to show you that again. Seen that one. So this page, I think you have seen like what I've done there. Like, just put this picture in because it was just nice. I liked it. It was really cute. And then I used this to like journal about not sleeping or sleeping a lot. I think it was when I slept a lot. And then I got these tags for in my jammy set, my pajama set. For my Christmas, so I stuck them in there as well because I thought it kind of went with the theme. And then I get this as well in the same pyjama set, but I could use this as a stencil if I like, but I don't know if I will because I kind of like it hanging down on here, so I don't know. I love this page. I think I showed you this page though, but I love it. It's one of my favourite pages. It's just a stencil, and then I just put in some, you know, just some jelly printed index cards just to use as like tags or whatever to journal on when I felt like journaling, not that I always do, or even just like the arrow if I just feel like doodling or whatever. And then you can see them through the next page. This is my sticker page, because Sugar's inspired me to do a sticker page. So I done that. Because I watch a lot of Sugar. I think it was Pink Poodle Crafts that inspired me to do this book from the gift bag. But Sugar's inspired a lot of it as well. I suppose there's a lot of inspiration from a lot of people, you know. And then I just put my little index card, my ATC that I've made on here on top of an index card. You've seen this one. You definitely have seen this one. This one here was just a personal matter that I just kind of put that in there to remind me where it was. This was just, you've seen that, I think, and you've seen my favourite perfumes. Although some of that might be changing because I got some perfumes for my Christmas there and my birthday and I quite like them. Then I done this page, had like a huge big sheet of these stickers, and I sat tonight and just filled the page, isn't it just adorable? I could have done it all cats, but I love dogs as well. I love cats and dogs, so I wanted to do a cat and dog page, and it's just so cute. And then we've got this. This is from the one of the movies. I can't remember the name of it now, but I got it out of a magazine. And then this was on a magazine as well. No, exactly that. It was just like the head, but the way I cut the page out, because it was actually something on the back that I was wanting. I think it was a cow or something, a funny cow, cartoon cow, and I was going to put that on. But when I turned it over, I seen this little guy, and I just thought it looked cute because it looks like he's got wee legs and stuff, so it was cute. So it was a happy accident, and then just an envelope, and I don't think there's anything in this. No. This was from junk mail that I got. It was a catalogue, and I love the bits, just like that. And you've seen my cuddly teddy page, I think you've seen this as well, this page. I did this as well for the gift tags, the sticky labels for Christmas paper, you know, you put your presents on. And then this was a tag that my brother gave me from his clothes that he got for Christmas. I told him to keep all his tags for me. And then this is just another page. That doily was like a pocket, but I glued it down because it was like ripping and stuff. This is from junk mail, it's just an envelope that I kind of painted on. And then there's just some notepaper in there, just so in case I want to doodle, or, well, no doodle, but write. That was a tag I made, jeez, I've seen that. And then I just put in all my ATCs, some of the ones I've made, some of the ones I've been given. And then I've got this in a swap, and it's a flip book. And I put it in there because I thought it was cool, and there were goodies and all that on in the things, but I took them all out, apart from these. I took them all out and I thought, you know what, I'll just use, keep this in case I want to journal, or, you know, I've put my own wee things in. Like, that tag's been written on, but she did give me other tags, it's written on, but she gave me other tags, and then this opens up to the letter that she sent me. But yeah, I just thought it was cute. And then look at there was a little thing in here, but there still is, there's a little ribbon in here. And then a little calendar. So yeah, it's just cute. And there's a little pocket here, I've already put something in there, so I really like it. And it's beautiful, so yeah. And then more of the ETCs. I was given this one, and I was given this one. My BFG page, I don't know if I showed you that, I think I did show you it, but I really love this page. This is one of my favourite pages as well. I just love how it turned out. You've seen this page, in fact there's actually pages missing because they fell out of the last thingy, because this one said loose, so I'm actually thinking about taking these pages and trying to fit them in these ones, and just no use this tag because it is really slack. But it's an envelope, and then we've got one of the pictures I drew as well. And then this is a little card sample, and then inside I wrote some lyrics to a song that I like. This is my feet were really sore one night, and I found this die cut thing, or whatever you want to call it, I don't know, template, and I stuck it in to dog my feet. I've had this for ages. I got it one of those crafty bits, you know, it was like scrappy bits and stuff like that. and craft bag things at the bottom. And yeah, I found that and I thought, you know what, my feet are so unbothered right about them, we'll use that. And then this is just the other parts of the stickers that I've stuck in the book or stuck somewhere else. So, and then this was originally maybe a pocket, but it didn't work as a pocket, so I've just made it as a little flip. So even if I want, I can maybe journal a wee bit on here, put a bit of paper on here, journal on it, or even just write on here and then use that to cover it up. So yeah, that is my journal so far, and I will try my best, guys, to get on and do some pages in it on camera. But yeah, I didn't really know what else to do tonight in the video, and I did say I would put one up soon, so there you go. I'm sorry it's so long, but a journal does take a while to go through, so and although I say you've seen that, you've seen this page, not everybody has seen it, but if you look, I'm going to be putting this into a playlist. There's a playlist, so if you go, if you're new to the channel and you're interested in seeing other flips or like maybe some pages that I've done in it, I've got a playlist and it's called Gift Bag Junk Journal, and if you just look at that, you'll see all the videos about the Gift Bag Junk Journal. I don't have a tutorial on how to make it though. I may try and attempt something on camera, but I'm no guarantee that it's going to really help you, because I'm not that good at it. But if you look in the first video, I think it actually gives you a link to Pink Poodle Crafts tutorial. Sorry guys, I can't think tonight. Let me speak properly. So this is one of the tags that my brother gave me. I can't take this off because it's actually glued onto this tag, but I thought it looked cool. So that's that. So another tag. I need to find a place to put them in the journal. And then I've got a Marvel tag, which he got, I think it was like a loungewear set, and it's blank in the back so I can journal on it. And then there's this, it's a crosshatch tag and it's really cute. And then this bit does lift up, but not that well, it's just so you can read it. Well, so I would probably put it like that or something, just to use like an arrow, because it looks like an arrow. So yep. And then I get this one, I really really like this, and I don't know how well you're going to be able to pick this up. You see skulls and stuff on it, and that cool. See how shiny the spiral bit is? That is one of the favourite tags that I got. That is so cool. Look at the hands, it's in the, and then there's another skull just here, or skeleton. There's one down here, I think, but I just think it looks so cool. Look at that, even the writing on the back, guys. Oh, focus, focus, focus. Can you see? It's like, you can't really see that well, but it's like the old fashioned writing. No, like the gothic type writing, it's just really cool. So it's one of my favourites. I don't know exactly where I'm going to put it yet, but I'm going to put it in one of my little pockets or my envelopes or whatever. And I don't think I'll be doing anything on it, because it's just really cool. You know, like these ones and that, I could always just put a bit of paper on these just to, you know, write on them, but I don't know. I don't know, guys. I kind of like them the way they are, just as little tags, you know. I know that people use tags to like journal on and stuff like that, but I just think they're cute. I can make tags, you know, but for these, I think they look so cool. So yeah, that's it guys, I'm going to go now because I've kept you long enough. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Sorry I'm a bit, you know, everywhere at the moment, it's just because I'm really tired. I haven't slept a lot this week. As I explained in my last video, I only had 2 hours sleep and hugged me day and stuff, so yeah, so I'm still trying to play catch up. I did doze off earlier and, you know, I woke up at 10 o'clock, but I'm getting tired again, so I will speak to you all soon. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I hope that I get this other software sorted so that I can use my Zoom and stuff like that, so you can get a better view of stuff, especially with the journal, because it is a big journal, so it's kind of big to hold up, you know. So anyway, I'll speak to you soon, guys. Bye.